Welcome to Road to Damascus. Our devotional for this evening is going to be taken from Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. And the basic discussion will be on the Word of God. And that's what that verse is about. So let's go into prayer first. And thank you for joining us. God, we come to you this evening. We praise you, we thank you, we magnify you, we exalt you, God, for you are God and there is no other. We ask that you, God, would give us wisdom, give us knowledge, give us understanding, and give us direction as we study the Word of God this evening. We ask that you would help us, God, to be mindful of your Word and to just apply it to our lives. It's in Jesus' name we pray, amen. So the word of God will come this evening from, as I said, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, and I'm reading from the New King James Version. And that version indicates, for the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. So once again, we're going to be looking at the Word of God. The Word of God is something that we should be reading every day. It's something that we should incorporate into our lives so that we know how to make right decisions. When it talks about discerning, it's being able to discern or establish something from being right or being wrong. And so we want to, as the body of believers and as those that are seeking, maybe you're not a believer yet and you're in a position where you're looking forward to get in line with the Word of God and to do what thus says the Lord. And so you're working on that now. So that's what we want to focus on this evening. So if you're not a believer and you're looking to become and come into the body of Christ, then we want to look at it as, I need to learn more about God's word. I need to really apply it to my heart and in my life. I need to understand what God's word says. There's many different translations. We do have to be careful of the different translations because there are a lot of them, but we need to be able to stick with a translation that helps us understand the word of God. I always use King James Version, but that's just a preference. And then I began to use the New King James Version because I noticed my pastor uses that, and then I also use the New International Version and the New Living Translation. So those are the ones I kind of work with that are beneficial for me. So I'm going to also read from the Amplified Version. And the Amplified Version says, for the word of God is living. So we're living and active, and we're active and full of power, making it operative, energizing, and effective. So let's just stop for a minute and think about that. The word of God is living. So when you pick up the word of God, whatever translation you decide to pick it up in, it's living. It can move. It can change you. Once you've been studying the word of God long enough, it may even make you cry. It may even bring tears to you because you're reading something that's really making sense from a spiritual standpoint. It also says it is sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating as far as the division of the soul and the spirit, the completeness of a person and of both joints and marrow, the deepest parts of our nature, exposing and judging the very thoughts and intentions of the heart. So the word of God works like a, I didn't have a sword, but here's a pair of scissors. The word of God is sharp. It's sharper than these scissors. And so the word of God is working, like it's cutting up. You could think of it as cutting up. And so when it talks about exposing and judging the very thoughts and intentions of the heart, it's exposing things that are in you that should not be in you once you become a believer. There's some things in us that need to be worked out of us. There's some things that we've been holding on, thinking it's the right way to go, the right thing to do. And it's not. It's get those things out, pull your scissors out again, and chop those things up. If you need to write it down, you have plenty of paper, even if you have to pull an envelope from some of the junk mail we get all the time and just write things down of what you need to get out of your life. You still got some anger issues, get them out. There's still some, you're coveting other people what they have. And by reading the word of God and continuing to keep it in your heart and continuing to put it first and foremost and cutting out those things, the anger, the resentment, the jealousy, you're jealous of somebody, We have to remember that God has made us all individuals, and we all individually have to have a relationship with him. We all individually need to come into his presence. We need to study his word. I think I've talked about this before. We need to pray. We need to fast. And sometimes we just need to sit quietly in his presence and have these things exposed and brought out of us, these thoughts and intentions of the hearts that are of the heart that are not in line with the word of God. And so we want to stay in the word of God. One of the good things that we need to do with God's word is memorize verses. It's something that, depending on who you are, you can either memorize it from reading it over and over again, or you can memorize it from writing it down. So I think it would be good for anybody, even if you haven't decided to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if you go to Romans 10, 9 and 10, it says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That's the word of God. And it's giving you an indication of what Jesus, the purpose of him coming here, that you believe in him and you confess him. And when you do that, that makes a difference in your life. So you can memorize scripture, and memorizing scripture and having that personal relationship with our Father is one of the most important things that we can do. So once again, the scripture for this evening was Hebrews 4:12, and it indicates from the Amplified, for the word of God is living and active. And from the New King James, it says, for the word of God is living and powerful. And so we want that. We want that word to be powerful in our lives. We want that word of God to have such power in us. It changes us. It changes us from being selfish, self-centered, narrow-minded. We ask God to give us understanding. We ask him to give us wisdom and knowledge. And all of those things are addressed in the word of God. So as we close this evening, Father, we thank you for this time in your word. We thank you for the word of God. For those that have not yet accepted you, Father, we ask that you would touch their hearts and their minds, that they would look at themselves and see, do I need to change? And it's not about following what you see others doing. It's following Christ. It's following the word of God. It's following what God's word says. God was no respecter of persons. He didn't make a difference between the Jews and Greeks. He would go and talk to all of them. And so we have to learn that the word of God makes that difference in our lives. It takes us from being closed-minded to opening our mind up to what God wants us to do and the way God wants to change us. So Father, we thank you this evening for your word. We ask that you would continue to reveal yourself to us. And then we also repent of any sins, God, that we may have committed by thought, word, and deed. God, whatever we've done that was out of line and said, or whatever it was, God, we repent of those things. And we ask that you would just cover us right now. Thank you for this time. We ask that you would bless us and keep us, and those under the sound of my voice, that they would stay in your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.